Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. The U.S. Supreme Court rules Donald Trump has some immunity from criminal charges for trying to reverse the 2020 election results. The case will now return to the U.S. District Judge Tanya Chutkan, who previously ruled Trump had no immunity from the charges. Now, Chutkan will have to reassess each allegation in the indictment based on the Supreme Court's finding and determine point by point which action by Trump was official conduct and which was private. Trump is now likely to reach the November elections with only one of the four criminal cases against him having gone to trial. Now, over in China, non-Chinese residents of Hong Kong and Macau will now be able to enter the country more easily. This after Beijing eased visa rules to further integrate the semi-autonomous cities into national development plans. Starting July 10, long-term residents who are not Chinese nationals will be eligible for a five-year permit to enter the mainland, multiple times for up to 90 days per visit. The policy aims to support the growing number of non-Chinese visitors from Hong Kong and Macau for business and leisure purposes. Still in China, its best-selling car brand BYD sold a record 1 million electric and hybrid cars in the second quarter. The sales were driven in part by the company's move to reduce prices across most models earlier this year, sacrificing profitability to target gasoline models made by foreign brands. Meanwhile, pushback from the U.S. and the EU over China's EV exports could undermine BYD's global ambitions in key markets. On to more news, NVIDIA is set to be charged by the French antitrust regulator for its alleged anti-competitive practices. Reuters reports the so-called Statement of Objections or charge sheet would follow Dawn raids in the graphics card sector in September last year, which sources said targeted NVIDIA. The world's largest maker of chips has seen demand for its chips jump following the release of its generative AI application, ChatGPT. This triggered regulatory scrutiny on both sides of the Atlantic. Meanwhile, Northern Data reportedly speaking with potential advisors about a U.S. initial public offering of its AI unit that could fetch a valuation of as much as $16 billion. Bloomberg reports, under the current plan, Northern Data would list an entity comprising its cloud computing activities, dubbed Taiga, as well as its data centers called Ardit, on the NASDAQ as early as the first half of next year. Shares of Northern Data have fallen about 5% this year, giving it a market value of about $1.4 billion. And finally, Steve Ballmer surpassing Bill Gates to become the sixth richest man in the world. This, the first time that the former chief executive officer of Microsoft has been wealthier than the company's co-founder. The move came as Microsoft shares rose to a fresh record, bringing their total gain this year to 21%. More than 90% of Ballmer's $157 billion net worth is in Microsoft shares. Gates, on the other hand, has diversified his $156.7 billion fortune in Cascade Investment and waste management company Republic Services. Gates has also been slowly reducing his fortune through philanthropy. Well, the Energy Regulatory Commission admits it is not sure if Meralco's power rates are fair and reasonable. Lawmakers have blamed the commission for what they call Meralco's confusing rate-setting processes. ERC commissioners earlier dismissed all motions questioning the power provider's distribution rate as it charges an average of 1 peso and 35 centavos per kilowatt hour. Meralco already refunded 40 billion pesos to its customers, but some petitioners insist this amount is not enough and Meralco should be charging less. Now on to another energy-related news. No reprieve for consumers in the first week of July as oil and cooking gas prices are increasing. Pump prices will see as much as 95 centavo price hike today, with gasoline having increased by more than 3 pesos in the last 3 weeks alone. The cost of an 11-kilogram LPG tank, meanwhile, also up by nearly 6 pesos this month. The Energy Department still citing tensions in the oil-rich Middle East as the reason for the consecutive price hikes. Bilateral relations and shared regional issues were high on the agenda when President Marcos met Malaysia's foreign minister at Malacanang Palace. The Presidential Communications Office reported this on Monday without going into specifics. Marcos reportedly saying the Philippines will remain in close coordination with Malaysia. The visit of Kuala Lumpur's top diplomat to the Philippines comes over a year after Marcos's state visit to that country, where he secured over $285 million in investment pledges. The Philippines is Malaysia's ninth major trading partner, with bilateral trade amounting to $8.1 billion in 2023.